Yes, very good morning dear students.
Welcome back to online physics class. Grade 9. See dear students, what I just am going to discuss with you, equations of motion using general method. So how we can derive equations of motion using general method. Students, you know, there are four equations of motion but in CBSE we just learn three equations of motion. What are that? V equal to u plus at, first one watch, v equal to u plus at, s equal to ut plus half at square, and third one is v square minus u square equal to 2as. And now we can, here we can learn fourth one, that is s equal to u plus a n minus half, or s equal to u plus a by 2 into 2 n minus 1. Both are same, right? So here we can calculate this for this s nth second, distance traveled by the body in nth second. That is the formula. How we can derive that, I will discuss with you. Right, and main important point, when we can use these four equations of motion, means compulsory an object should be moving with uniform acceleration. So whenever object should be moving with uniform acceleration, then we can choose these four equations of motion. Hence we call these are equations of motion are considerable only in the condition of uniform acceleration. Whenever any object or a body is moving with uniform acceleration is nothing but what? Equal change in velocities with equal intervals of time. Whenever a body is moving with uniform acceleration, it has equal change in velocities with equal intervals of time, then we can say that it is moving with uniform acceleration. So whenever it is moving with uniform acceleration, we can use these four equations of motion. Just before deriving these four equations of motion, just I will take one diagram. See, and one more thing, here we can discuss about motion in a straight line. Shocked itself name is motion in a straight line or kinematics. See, for example, I am taking one object is moving with initial velocity u, and this object is moving with uniform acceleration a. After some time t, it covers with velocity v, and it is acquired some velocity, right? It is actually moving with initial velocity v, covered distance s. Understand? So whenever object or a body is moving with initial velocity u, moving with uniform acceleration, after some time t, it acquires, this object or body acquires velocity v, covered distance, yes. See, first I'm taking, this is the first equation of motion, and it is the second equation of motion, it is a third, and it is a fourth. Understand? See here, these three equations of motion, just I will discuss with you relations. What is the relation of equation 1? See, I will derive first equation 1, I will take v equal to u plus a. It is, see, it is a velocity time relation. What equation 1 tells? It is the velocity time relation. Velocity time relation. Because the body having initial velocity u, and of course it is moving with constant acceleration, so then only it is a relation between velocity and time. And see, next second, s equal to ut plus half a square. So here it is equation 2. It is a, here s proportional to t square. This s proportional to t square. So distance travelled by the body is directly proportional to the square of time elapsed. So then here it is displacement. Then it is a displacement time relation, or magnitude of distance. Displacement time relation, or magnitude of displacement. Magnitude of displacement also we can call distance. And see,
another one thought, what is v square minus u square equal to 2ax? V square minus u square equal to 2ax. Here the third one is v square is directly proportional to distance traveled by the body. Then it is a velocity or displacement relation. Velocity displacement relation or velocity magnitude of displacement. So this is the relations. Understand? So whenever in the problem, the problem being like velocity time relation, then we can choose this first equation. The problem, it will be behave like it will shows like displacement time relation, we can choose second equation. And it is a velocity displacement relation, we can choose third equation motion. So whenever the distance traveled by the body in the nth second, distance traveled by the body in nth second means we can choose this equation. What is that? S equal to u plus a by 2 n minus a by 2 2n minus 1. So distance traveled by the body in one second means we can choose second equation. 2 seconds means we can choose second equation. N second means we can choose second equation. But distance of the body in the nth second means we can choose this equation of motion. So these are the 4 equations of motion and their relations. So now our aim is derive the equations of motion individually. How we can derive the equations of motion? I think you know very well in CBS itself we have derived these equations of motion except the 4. So today just I am going to discuss with you one by one the relations of motion. Right, one by one derivations also. Yeah. See, first one, v equal to u plus a. V equal to u plus a. So we have to derive this equation. It is a velocity time relation. But we know to derive this, we know acceleration equal to change in velocity divided by time t. Change in velocity is nothing but what? Delta v, or final velocity minus initial velocity. So whenever an object is moving with initial velocity, after some time t, it acquires some velocity. So this velocity is called final velocity, right? And after some time t, and it is covered distance s in the uniform acceleration. Just to remember the diagram. So change in velocity is nothing but what? Final velocity by time t. So this is a acceleration, an equation for. So you can do here cross multiplication. Then here v minus u equal to at. Then it is a v equal to u plus a. So here it is a vt. So from equation 2, it is known as a velocity time relation. So this is the derivation of first equation of motion. And next one is second equation of motion. What is that? Second equation of s equal to ut plus of at square. So to this, so what we have to do to do this to calculate second equation of motion, so what we have to do, please tell. And before that, just I am discussing with you. So to derive s equal to ut plus half a t square, s equal to ut plus half a t square, first we want to know what is the average velocity formula. What is the average velocity formula? So the average velocity formula is v plus u by 2. V plus u by 2. We know distance equal to r is speed equal to r, average speed equal to distance by time. Then distance equal to average speed. I am taking here this average speed or magnitude of velocity. Magnitude of velocity, we can choose
स्पीड आल्सो एवरेज स्पीड आल्सो
देन सो एवरेज स्पीड बाय टाइम सो जस्ट आई एम कंसीडरिंग डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल्ड बाय द बॉडी इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एवरेज वेलोसिटी इनटू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एवरेज वेलोसिटी इनटू टाइम सो बट वी नो मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एवरेज वेलोसिटी इज v प्लस u बाय 2 इनटू p then we know first equation of motion v is nothing but what u plus a then u plus a b plus u by 2 into p then u plus u it is a 2u then 2u plus a b by 2 into p then it is a 2u into p 2u p and this two will be cancelled each other then it is a u p plus a b into p a b square by 2 a b square by R 1 by 2 AB. So this is the equation of second equation of motion. So S equal to UT plus half AT square. S equal to UT plus half AT square. And how we can derive this average velocity? How we can derive average velocity? Anyone tell? See for example, distance equal to speed by time. Distance equal to speed by time. So for example, if you mention the in the speed of v, can mention u plus a t by 2, u plus a t by 2, but v equal to u plus a t, then v minus u equal to a t, then s equal to u plus v minus u by t, right? Then again we are getting s equal to v by t. So this is a s equal to v by 2. So but already we discussed with you average velocity or average speed equal to v plus u by 2. Understand?
Yes.
So next one I am going to discuss with you. So now just I will give you work. Already in CBSE itself I discussed with you how average velocity equal to v plus u by 2. Just you can type. Right? Or else I will we can discuss here in detail. And next one is
what is it?
Third equation of motion. What is that? Third equation of motion. See, third equation of motion means v square minus u square equal to 2s. This is the velocity displacement relation. So to derive this, I am choosing v equal to u plus a t, then v minus u equal to a t, then t equal to v minus u by a. So we got it t equal to v minus u by a. And next one, we know distance equal to average velocity into time. Then average velocity equal to v plus u by 2 into time. And time equal to v minus u by a. Then v plus u by 2 into v minus u by a. Right? If you see, it is a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b is nothing but what? A square minus b square. Then s equal to v square minus u square by 2a. So then v square minus u square equal to 2a. Yes. V square minus u square equal to 2a. Yes. So here, it is a v square is directly proportional to s. It is a velocity displacement, a velocity distance, magnitude of displacement. So these are three equations of motion already we learned in CBSE itself. Now we are going to discuss fourth equation of motion. So that is S equal to u plus a into n minus half. For example, I am taking one object is moving with a straight line. Just I am considering second equation of motion that is just equal to ut plus half at square. That is equation 1. So this object is moving with, when object is moving with n seconds, see, n seconds, I am taking this as S1, right? So n second means in the place of, it is actually st. It is s proportional to t square. Displacement, distance, dimension, displacement, dimension. Magnitude of distance or displacement, dimension. So So in the place I substitute n, then we get I will get s equal to un plus o of an square. So for example, one particle is moving with n minus 1 second. One particle is moving with n minus 1 second. I am taking it is a s2. So then it is s of n minus 1. Then instead of t, you can n minus 1 you can take. N minus 1 square. So this particle is moving from here to here n seconds, and this particle is moving from here to here m minus 1 second. So this part is nth second. This part is nth second. So you can take here it is a s n. Yes, nth. So that one you have to substitute here. S nth equal to s1 minus s2. So this particle is moving from here to here n seconds. For example, it is moving from here to here 30 meter, and from here to here it is moving to 20 meter. Then how much? If you want to get this one, means from here to here, how we can do this 30 minus 20 will get it is 20. Sorry, 10. Understand? From here to here, it is moving with 30 meter. From here to here, it is moving with 20 meter. Then it is how much? 10. How it will come? 30 minus 20. So then further, S1 minus S2, we will get this one. That only here are the main thing, how we can derive this. And see, in S, nth means S1. S1 is nothing but what? I am taking this S1 means N. So un plus of an square minus s2 is nothing but what? Un u of n minus 1 plus of a of n minus 1 square. This is a derivation, somewhat derivation is there, we can do this. Right? And see, just I am going here. So then s nth equal to un plus of an square minus minus u into n, un minus u into 1 minus un minus u plus half a, this a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2a, right? Then S nth equal to un plus half an square minus un minus u minus un minus u plus, just I will send this half a inside. I will send the half a inside. Means what happened? Half a. And next one is what? Half a into n square, it means half a n square plus 1 into half a is nothing but what? Plus half a. So minus 2n a by 2. Minus 2n a by 2. Understand?
Yes.
So now we can see here itself. Just as a note, just you can remember, see here. Then S n equal to Sn equal to un plus half an square. Now I will set this minus inside, right? Then is minus into an, minus un, minus into plus u, right? And minus into plus, minus half an square. So minus into plus, minus half a, then minus into plus. So this here, see, already 2 cancel, then minus into minus plus n. See which terms will be cancelled each other. See, minus half n square plus half n square cancel each other. And the un plus un minus un cancel each other. Then what remains? S n equal to u plus an minus half a. So here S n equal to u, in these two terms a is common, then a can take common, then a into n minus half. So this is a derivation of S n.
Understand my point? Whenever the particular object is moving with the nth second, so which we have to choose means S equal to u plus a into n minus half. So no problem, just I will send this one to your notes. I will send notes in your group at the time, right?
So this is about how to derive a distance traveled by the body in nth cycle.
Right?
Yes. So everyone understand or not?
Just once you can see.
So any doubt in this, means you can ask, no problem.
Any doubt?
See, again I am telling four equations of motion. B equal to u plus ad, s equal to ut plus half a t square. And v square minus v square equal to 2as and s equal to u plus a into n minus 1, right? Or s equal to u plus a by 2 into 2 minus 1. How it will come? S equal to u plus 2 into n, 2n minus 1 by 2. Then it is a 2n minus 1 by 2, I will write this here, right? Then s equal to u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1 also. So it is a velocity time relation, it is a displacement time relation, it is a velocity displacement relation. The distance traveled by the body in the nth cycle. This is the four equations of motion using a general method, right? So now just I am going to discuss with you one problem. The problem is the iron you should write. The velocity of a particle varies with the displacement. The velocity of a particle varies with the displacement. The velocity of a particle problem. Problem 1, the velocity of a particle varies with displacement, is given by v equal to root of 3x plus 16, right? And find here, find a and u. It means find acceleration and initial velocity. The problem is velocity with the displacement. It is a relation between velocity and displacement. So whenever the problem will give me, just you have to try. So try to bring out which equation of motion you have to use here. So already I told velocity displacement relation, third equation of motion. See, we know v square minus u square equal to 2s. So it is a velocity displacement relation, no? Right or not? Yes. See now, so I am taking the problem v equal to root of 3x plus 16. So how we can calculate here a and u, right? See, so now first I am squaring and goes in equation 1, it becomes v square equal to 3x plus 16, right? So now you send this 16 this side, then it is a v square minus 16 equal to 3x. Understand? So then you can see here, so now from this equation, what is the u? U means nothing but what? V square minus u square equal to 2x. Then u is like there, it is a 16, right or not? Then here, see this 3x behaves 2as. See, it behaves like this equation 2. So equation 2 behaves like v square minus u square equal to 2as. So here we have to find out u and we have to find out a, right? So see here, it is u square equal to 16 here. Then u equal to 4. Understand? Now here 2a equal to 3, then a equal to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is nothing but what? I think 1.5. 1.5 meter per second square, 4 meter by second. 4 meter by second. So this is the problem, how if they will do the problem, means how we can do, means this is a procedure. Understand? The velocity of a particle varies with the displacement. They are given v equal root of 3x plus 16. So how we find, means like this we can find. Understand? Yes. Yes, dear students, now I am going to discuss with you the equations of motion using calculation method. Calculation method means integration method. Calculation method is nothing but what? Integration method. So before we can calculate this integration method, I think you don't have idea in integration, but actually I want to start integration only whenever I am starting foundation. So that time we can start at what is that, units and dimensions. So today in our next class I will start and we can learn this integration also. First, what are the problems we have to require?
So those formulas just we can discuss here, integrations.
Today just I am going to discuss with you integration, some formulas, whatever we require. We are not going to deep into the physics, right? See, it is an integration. Integration symbol is like this. This is the symbol of integration. Understand? So integration of, for example, I am taking dx. Here d is nothing but derivation, derivative. And integration is nothing but what?
This is symbol, integration, right?
See, for example, I am taking a to b. It is a means lower limit, b means upper limit. I am not going deeply, just whatever the formulas are required. So those things only we have to discuss here, right? So here always derivation and integration symbol will be cancelled each other. Or else first the formula of integration of dx, just you have to remember like that. The formula of integration of dx is nothing but x. And here we have to write upper limit, lower limit, how it is means. It is a and it is a b. Understand? So then how we can substitute this means, it is a b minus a. Instead of x we can choose b. Why? Because instead of x we can choose b. It means upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit. So how it is means, see, for example I am taking, so f of x, f of x, just I want to apply limits. This is a, it is a b. How we can apply limits means upper limit minus lower limit. So here instead of x I am substituting upper limit minus lower limit. So this is the first problem, first formula, right?
Yes.
Next one. So integration of x power n, integration of x power n, right? Integration of x power n. For example, you take a, b. The integration of x power n is nothing but x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This is a formula, right? X power n plus 1, n plus 1 by n plus 1. So for integration, we can get constant also. We are, whenever we want to calculate constant, that time we can choose. But not, for us, no need about that constant. So for example, here I want to substitute, here this is the limits, a to b. So instead of n, we want to substitute that limits, then upper limit, x b plus 1 by b plus 1 minus lower limit, x a plus 1 by a plus 1. This is the most formula we can choose in calculation method also. Right, for example, I will do one problem here, see, integration of x square 1 to 2 dx. Yeah, dx is very important to you students. Understand this? That's the formula is like that. See how we can calculate the formula is like in the form of x power n. The formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This n plus 1 is nothing but 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Sorry. X cube dx, no? X cube dx is nothing but x 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, then it is x cube by 3, x cube by 3, this is 1 to 2, why? Because it is n plus 1, no? N plus 1 is nothing but 2 plus 1, 2 plus 1 is nothing but 3. So instead of x, you can substitute these 2, then it becomes 2 cube by 3 minus 1 cube by 3. So 2 cube is nothing but what? 8 by 3 minus 1 cube is nothing but 1 only. So 8 by 3, 2 cube by 3 and 1 cube by 3, minus 1 cube by 3, then 8 by 3 minus 1 by 3, that is 7 by 3. So this is the way how we can calculate formulas of integration. The main formula we can choose integration this one, in this one in physics. And the remaining whatever the formulas will be there, at that time I will discuss with you. So next class I will discuss with you calculation, equations of motion using calculation method also, dear students. Thank you.